Hi guys, and welcome to another WordPress tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we've covered this before, but I had an email or a message from somebody that said they missed the part in one of my videos where we remove this line between the sidebar and the main content here. And we do this with CSS. And sometimes that can be real hard to trace. I'm using Google Chrome here, which is awesome because it's got the fantastic inspector tools. You just hit F12 on your keyboard and it'll bring them up here. Or you just click on the particular area that you want to highlight and right click and go down to inspect, and it'll select that area for you. Now this particular line is not obvious at all. You'd think it be a sort of a right margin on this content or a left margin on this content, but it's not. If we have a look at this content here, you're not going to find it down in the CSS here. And to edit this CSS, once you've got your inspector open, you want to make sure you're on elements and on the right pane styles. You may have yours in a different area here. You can click on these little three buttons and have it on the side. Or you can have it unlock so it's just floating in the middle here. But for me, I prefer it on the bottom. That usually works for me so I can see the whole content quite well here. So let's go about finding this little fella right here and see if we can't remove it. As I say, it looks like it would be a margin on the right, and it's not. It's not on that section, and it's not on the sidebar. If we go down to the sidebar here, or if we just right click and select on it, here's the sidebar. But as you can see, when you select it, that line actually runs further up. So it's kind of telling you right there that it's not part of that section. And where it is, it's actually part of the main content for the page. So if we go up, I'll try and zoom in on some of this code here. And here's the main area, ET. I'm using the Divi theme here, which is absolutely awesome. If you want to try it out, you can try it out from a link below this video. So here we are, we've got the main area. If we slide down just a little bit, here's the container. And then if you look at that blue and green highlighted area, it's within there. It's actually before that. So if we go down one more, I don't know if you can tell, but it's highlighted that line blue. I hope that comes out in the video. If I go off of it, or if I go off of it, it's gray. If I go back onto that before right there, it's blue. So that's kind of telling me that's the bit I want to get rid of right here. So I'm going to click on it, just left click on the before. I'm going to go over to my CSS here. I'm going to scroll down to see if I can actually find it. Well, there's not much in here. I think it's going to be right there. And what I did, I got off of the before and highlighted the container class above it, which is over here. I've gone all the way down to the bottom and it says main content container dot before. Background color, let's take that away. And you can see that it's not displaying at all there. What it's actually displaying, but it's got no background color, so you can't see it. So to get rid of it, I'm going to right click just by this little curly black bracket here, which will open a new line. I'm just going to put in a bit of CSS code, display, colon, none. And that will make it not display at all. Right, so that's fine, but how do we actually keep it like that? Because once I refresh this page, it's going to come back. So let's copy this main content container before just left click and drag. I'm just going to go down to the end of the display none. Now we need to go to our theme options. I've got mine open here. It's in your main control panel here, down to Divi, theme options, and it's scrolled down right at the bottom here. And I'll just start at the top here. I've commented out a lot of this because we've actually done this before. So I've commented it out so you can see it. And I'll just give it a title, ../*/, so we can find it again. I'm talking, so I typed that wrong. ?, not? And then in the middle of the stars, you can put your comment. I'm just going to say remove sidebar. All right. So now we just need to drop down a couple and paste in that bit of code. And it's flagged it. I need to actually put a closing curly bracket on the end of that. That's really important. It won't work unless you put a closing curly bracket on it. Once that's saved, hit save, go back to the page, get rid of the inspector. Now when I refresh, that should stay the same. It should still not be there. So there you go. That's how to remove that little divider or sidebar between the main content and the category section over here. Now, if like I say, I'm using the Divi theme, which is great. A lot of most themes nowadays will have a custom CSS area so that when you update your theme, it won't destroy all your custom CSS. A lot of them, it's in the customizer. With Divi also, it's in the customizer. And if we look down here, here's the additional CSS, and it's exactly the same as it's the same bit. There's that bit that we just put in there. Like I say, most themes have that now. If they don't have that, let's just go back to the control panel. Most WordPress themes will let you do it in an editor right here. But this is really important. You have to remember, if you're going to put it in your editor, then you need to make a child theme, because when your theme updates, it'll actually overwrite any CSS that you've put in there. So that was short and sweet. I hope that's answered your question, Maria. I gave you the code before, so I'm sure you've probably done this by now. But that is how to get rid of that little dividing line between the two sections. So I hope that's been helpful to you. If it has, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web development, have a look down below. We've got some great free courses, and there's also some premium courses down there with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. So do have a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.